this is going to be a crazy show today. I mean, crazy. Oh my God, what's been going on in the news? I mean, y'all see it. Y'all see it. Churches burning. The Ku Klux Klan, the FBI has been called in. What in the world is going on? This is crazy out here. But you know what? It's going to get crazier. It's supposed to get crazier. I don't know any place in the world that hasn't read Revelations. Even the Muslims and everybody else that don't believe in Jesus know about the Bible. And they know that Revelations is true. So what's next for the church? What do we do? What's going to happen? I'm seeing a lot of things on Facebook. Man, I got to tell you, my Facebook was going crazy the other day. I made a few statements, and people just, like the Joker said, lost their mind. You make one little statement, and people just lose their mind. Well, we're going to talk about those statements, too, because a lot of them, I was being facetious, and then the other ones, I was being truthful. And we're going to talk about the truthful statements, and we're going to talk about the facetious statements, too. Oh, man. I mean, these last couple of days have been crazy. When I say the churches have been burning, six churches have burned since this shooting at the one church in South Carolina, in Charleston. Are you kidding me? People are burning churches again? Is this attack on black people or is this attack on the black church? We're going to talk about that after this. All right? I don't get it. Maybe it's me. Maybe I'm being a little sensitive. But I guess, you know, I got a right to be. Give me that joy I can't explain. An extra piece that'll ease my pain. Want that love that'll never change.
Give me that power to walk away. Yeah. When another God wants to take your place. As much of you as I can take. Whoa. Give me that. Oh, oh, oh. Anybody ready? Oh, oh. Ready for his glory. Oh, oh. If you are sick of a life, oh, oh. Let me tell you the story. Oh, oh. Every place that's dark. Oh, oh. He will bring it to light. Uh-oh. Hypocritical hearts, backsliders, liars, time to get right. Uh-oh. See, I include myself. Uh-oh. I cast my own stone. Uh-oh. I'm the man in the mirror, y'all. Uh-oh. I can see my wrong. Uh-oh. But I'm here by grace. Through Christ by faith. Uh-oh. I had to make that choice. I had to open up my mouth and say, give me that joy I can't explain. Add extra peace that'll ease my pain. Want that love that'll never change. Give me that. Give me that power to walk away. When another God wants to take your place. As much of you as I can take. Give me that. Oh, anybody tired? You want the show to end? Uh-oh. Get the actors off stage. Uh-oh. And let church begin. Uh-oh. Do you want a revolution? Uh-oh. You want to hear a new song? See, God is cleaning up house. Uh-oh. And first he's starting right at home. No more miracle water. Prayer cloths for money and fame. See, everybody got a title. But do you know your name? Uh-oh. If we humble ourselves, people, uh-oh, fall on our face, uh-oh, and ask God, everything in me that's not right, take it away.
Yeah, give me that joy that I can't explain. Add extra peace that'll ease the pain. I want that love that'll never change. Give me that. Ooh, I want the power to walk away. When another God wants to take your place. Much of you, Lord, as I could take.
I see you.
Give me that.
One more time.
Give me that.
One more time.
Yeah, give me that joy that I can't explain. Yeah. And it's your peace that'll ease the pain. I want that love that.
into the nostrils of man. And sovereign God who predestined creation before time began. I want the God who with brilliance and elegance decorated darkness with stars. The God who orchestrates the future. At the same time, he knows where you are. Give me that God who supplies my needs, cause he owns all the cattle on the hill. Yeah. And he's the God who wipes my tears and provides enough to pay all my bills. And give me that God, that's the God I'm talking
give
about.
Me that
give
God.
Me that God, that's the God I'm talking
that
about.
God.
Give me that. I'm at a loss of words now. I'm so happy you make me happy now.
So, I guess people think Christians are supposed to be weak. I mean, how could you blame them? How could you blame them? We do nothing but sit by and forgive people. But is that what God wants us to do? Is to forgive everybody with no reaction? I don't believe that's God's will for us to not react to anything. You know, just let people just walk all over us and go into, you know, I forgive you ball and curl up and just ignore everything else. I don't believe that's God's will for us. Maybe I'm a little more vigilant and I believe in fighting people. I don't know. That's just me. I mean, unless you call me and say something, then, you know, you're going to hear me rant and rave all day. But listen to this. 6 churches burned over the country over the last couple of days. The FBI is called in because they think it now is a hate crime. Really? Really? Who are they hating on? Are they hating on black people or hating on Christians? Which one? Because just like we shouldn't have been that mad about gays having the right to marry, why should people be that mad at us for coming out and saying what we feel that's a part of our beliefs? So now people are mad at Christians because we're mad at a lifestyle. But people are mad at what we're saying. So they have the freedom to live the way they want to, but we don't have the freedom to say what we want to. Something's not right about that. And because America is reacting the way it is, we're burning churches and killing kids and attacking the church, we're idly standing by saying, well, what goes on in their bedroom doesn't affect me, so I'm going to just say it's wrong and then I'm going to move on. Well, we said it was going to open some doors. I don't know why people didn't understand why it wasn't going to open some doors. But it is, trust me, it will open some doors. You're going to see a lot more craziness coming up in the next few years of now that gays are able to marry. And I'm not blaming gay people. What I am blaming what I am blaming is the perversion, the sin. Because now the people that are gay will see a new level of craziness even in a homosexual lifestyle. Check it. A pedophile, a man that's a pedophile, decides, now I want to marry this 15-year-old boy because it's legal in my state. I can marry a 15-year-old boy in my state because he's legally an adult. So he manipulates the boy and marries him. Now, this young man is married to this pedophile when the guy actually should have been in jail. What about the other way around? A woman that takes advantage of a young man or a young woman. See, this can go a lot of different ways, people. You thought it was just about marriage, and it's not just about marriage. It's about perverting marriage. See, let me explain something to you. Whatever the Lord has mandated good, the devil has to pervert it. What? You don't believe me? You don't believe me? Are you serious? I don't even need to go to the Bible for this. That's how good I am at this. I don't even need to go to the Bible for this. Check it. Satan thought himself so powerful and so beautiful and higher than the other angels that he also tried to raise himself above God. And God threw him out. What does this have to do with anything that I was just saying? What statement am I trying to make? Satan was the angel of music. God made music in order for us to give him worship. What has Satan done to the music? He has perverted it. Boom, that's one. Or as we say in the office, kaboom. No. All right, that's one. Marriage is a sanctity that God ordained between a man and a woman. In the Bible, it says that men will become lovers of their own flesh, and that is an abomination to the Lord. Okay? It's in the Bible. What is Satan trying to do to the sanctity of marriage? See, y'all thinking it's about the gays. It's not about the gays. It's about what Satan is trying to do. He's trying to pervert every single aspect of what God has deemed beautiful and wonderful and lovely in his sight. Don't believe me? One more. God loves us more than he loves any creation that he's ever made. He holds us higher than the angels. One, because he gave us choice. He gave us a choice to choose him or Satan. No angel has that option. Angels don't have the option. They do what God says and that's it. They don't have the option of choice. They to praise God and that's it. They don't have the option of choice. Man has the option of choice. That's why God has regarded us higher than the angels. All right? He told us to subdue the earth and be fruitful and multiply and have dominion over the earth. When God created earth and everything that in it, he saw that it was good. So now what does Satan want to do is he wants to pervert it. So now we have all these different things that help kill what we live on. Are y'all with me still? Are you with me? All right. So if that's the case, if Satan is to pervert every single thing that God ordained good, why are we mad at people? We're mad at the wrong person. Or the wrong thing. How about the wrong spirit? We're mad at the wrong thing behind the thing that we're mad at. How about that? I won't even give him that kind of credibility, whatever that word is. I won't even give him that. We're mad at the wrong thing. Why don't we get mad at the right thing? How about this? We're here in Detroit. Our station originates out of Detroit, Michigan, one of the most church towns, church cities, church counties in the United States of America. Why is the Church of Satan so comfortable setting up shop here? They even said it in the paper. We're comfortable being here. This is like home. We're comfortable being in Detroit. I think we're going to build a statue and send it up to Oklahoma, and which they are, and which they're going to show on July 11th. They're going to reveal it on July 11th in a city full of churches. And I've not seen one pastor. I've seen people on Facebook get mad. I've seen people on Twitter get mad about it. I have not seen one pastor go down to where that place is and sit in front of that place and pray. Not one. Why haven't I done it? Because this one thing. I brought it to your attention. I know. I'm praying about it. If I go down there, who's to say that I won't get hurt? But if a leader goes down there, and now the leader is the leader. He's recognizable. He's not going to just be down there and get hurt and not nobody know about it. I could end up in a garbage can. Nobody even know about it except for the people that care about me. And there's a few of y'all. Oh, my goodness. Man, I don't know, church. I don't know. Getting back to my original statement, I know why people see us as weak. I know why people think of our religion as nothing. I do. Do I like it? Do I have a choice? Yeah, I have a choice. But does my choice matter? I got people on Facebook. Let me go to Facebook real quick. Because y'all not hearing me. And I'm hoping to have a phone call soon from one of my friends from out of town. But I need y'all to see this. Because I made a few statements on Facebook and people have literally just went crazy. So let me go down to my first statement because I think my first statement was a doozy and I don't think people like me because of it. I know there's a few pastors out there that was like, you know, he's a nobody, you know, it doesn't matter what he say, you know. So we'll just ignore him. Because, you know, nobody's really listening to his station or nobody really sees what he's saying. So let me show you what I said. Or let me tell you what I said. So while everyone is on this fight against the gays, I'm about to bring the fight home. Church leaders, if you are sleeping with more than one person in your congregation or have babies by more than one, you are going to hell like the gays. Well, am I wrong? I don't know. Am I? Call me and tell me if I'm wrong. Let's go to another one. It said, prophetesses, all of you prophetesses, if you know that man is married, God did not prophesy to you that he was your husband. you're actually a prophet lie. Wow. I'm just waiting for the arrows. Next one says, if your church has a board member, now this is real crucial, because the other two I was kind of being facetious. I wasn't actually pointing them at you. Well, the first one I kind of was, when the pastors is sleeping in with the people in their churches and having babies by the ladies in their churches. They're going to hell too. If they don't repent of what they've done, they're going to hell too. So you could talk about gays being an abomination and that being the worst, that one worse sin than any sin that anybody could do. Well, God doesn't hold levels of sin. There's no levels in sin. There's only one sin that the Lord said that he cannot forgive. I'll tell you about that later. So this one statement I made is really, really aimed at the church. It's not aimed at a church. It's aimed at the whole church, the church body. And I said, if your church has a church board or a board of directors, then your church is operating in witchcraft. Man, I'm gonna leave that right there. That's hardcore. Man, that's hardcore. If your church is operating with a board or a board of directors, your church is operating in witchcraft. If you don't believe me, call me. I'll talk to you about it.
I don't really care about my past. Navy dropped me, but he picked me up. Always had his eye on me, that's a drop in love. Gotta remember that for times I feel like giving up. Life is hard, especially when your faith is low. Now that I came out this situation like a champ, I'm a boast up in his name, all glory goes to him. Yeah, King of Kings, my big homie. Too expensive for this world, so he done went and caught me. Took me in and showed me exactly what I was missing. After that, I couldn't believe it, I wouldn't listen. But that's in the past, I'm good off that, about that future business. To be in the past, for a real. Won't look back, never ever will. You see my past, I don't really care. You see my past. I don't really care about my past. I don't really care. Whoa, I don't care what all these people saying. I know he's there. I'm anticipating all that he said. Come in the past, look straight ahead, opposite of my past. And I'm not anxious, I know the vision that he gave me now. And I'm not tripping off being famous, I'm into following wherever he may go. Impossible, some may say, but my God is a God who can make a way. And I know that the vision is great, yeah. So I'm on one. If anybody with me, go ahead and wave your hand. Wave it all around like you just don't care. Wave it all around like you just don't care. Look him in the eye and tell him, yeah. Won't look back, never ever will. You see my past, I don't really care. You see my past, I don't really care about my past. Can't hold me down, I'm feeling fine, my future's bright. I've got it all as long as I got Jesus Christ. Can't hold me down, I'm feeling fine, my future's bright. I've got it all as long as I got Jesus Christ. Really don't care, really, really don't care now. Really don't care about the past now, now. I really don't care, really don't care. I really don't care. Everybody go ahead, tell them you really don't care.
I won't look back, never ever will. You see my past, I don't really care. 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 You see my past. I don't really care about my past. I don't really care about my past. I don't really care.
So, hold on. Let me take this call real quick. Real quick. Real quick. Real quick. Real quick. Hello, hello, hello.
Yeah, how you doing?
Who is this?
Bill McKinney.
Hey, Bill, this is Juan. How are you doing?
Hey, how you doing, man?
Hey, man, I don't know. It's been hard these last couple of days.
Yeah, I know. It's the country is changing. You know, the world is just headed towards the place that everybody says is going to happen. You know, it was already written. But now we have to face the music now, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Most definitely, I know. Because now, me and you are on Facebook. We're Facebook friends on Facebook, you know, obviously. But we started posting about being vigilant and taking control of, you know, and not letting people talk about our religion and being disrespectful toward us because they don't want us to be disrespectful toward them. And all of a sudden, people started losing their minds.
Yes, it's a sad situation. And see, it all goes to the relationship that you have with the Creator. Who is he to you? You know, is he just God to you? Someone you know, it's a myth, some story that you was told when you was young? Or is he somebody... that your grandmama, you know, forced you, your parents forced you to go to church and you mm-hmm. sit and listen to, or is he somebody that's your Lord? Is he a king to you, or is he your father? And it all goes to that category. Some people, he ain't nothing. Some people don't believe. So we have to live with people in the earth who don't see him for who he is, and they look at everything that goes on in this world and think that it just came out of thin air. Now that we're here, and we have, you know, he have children here, you know, and the children, the people that God is a father to, they're offended by everything that's happening in this country, you know? Mm-hmm. And it's all about people. I mean, are children going to stand up or are they going to just stay quiet? The reason why we're here is because they was quiet. And now the uproar is here because it's here. And it's something that's been said that's going to happen years ago. I mean, it's nothing towards those people who want to practice, you know, same sex. You know, that's been going on for centuries since, you know, Roman times,
before the flood. Since before the flood. So this is, homosexuality is not nothing new on the earth.
Yeah. So now we at the place where the rights, I mean, we come to a time where we have to actually face the music. Because, yes, it's been here for centuries. And I always looked at it, whatever a person do with their life, that's on them. If they want to rob somebody, that's their life. They want to rape somebody, that's their life. But they're not going to do it in my knowledge. You know what I'm saying? They're not going to do it without me, like, contesting that. Like, oh, no, man, you did that to that girl, we're going to make sure that you know, you got to get penalized for that because you can't just go around raping people.
Right.
You know?
Right.
So we got to have that mindset is when you see something, I mean, not bashing people because some people we don't know. We don't know what kind of mind or condition some of those people is. I talked to one a couple of days ago, and I said, hey, you know, I ain't got nothing really against how you live your life because you can live your life how you want as long as you don't push it on me, you know? And I think the uproar now is the law of the land. That's the biggest subject, is them making it law of the land and shoving it down our throats and want to put it into our children's face and condition their minds and stuff, something to confuse our children. The children of God, we look at it and we say, God is not an author of confusion, but of peace. But how can we have peace if it's confusion? You know, you got two worlds that's colliding right now. That's the mm-hmm. world that it's really actually two seeds on this earth battling.
But listen to this, Bill. Listen to this. These are the same people that didn't want Christianity in schools, didn't want us pushing Christianity down nobody's throat. You see what I'm saying? Didn't want prayer in schools because we don't want them to pray to your God because, you know, we might not believe in that God. We don't want you pushing Christianity on us in the courthouse. We don't, and they trying to do everything that they possibly can to remove God from everywhere, but then they want to replace it with homosexuality. Like, you don't want us to cram God down your throat, but now you want us to take the take homosexuality down our throats?
Yeah, and that's what we have a problem with. That's the problem that we are facing, and we facing it where, hey, you know, listen, you can do what you want to do, but just don't throw it down my throat. I'm not throwing, you know, like you said, I'm not forcing you to receive Jesus your Lord or receive Allah or whoever you want to serve in from your belief. We're not shoving it down your throat, so don't shove that down our throat. Because, I mean, if you look at it, that's not a normal state of living, you know? So it's like, why I got to deal with that? Why I have to teach my children when they see that stuff happening in the streets? Why I got to just sit there? Of course they're going to eventually see, but I'm saying if you shove it, the way they shoving it down our throat is they put it on TV, they put it in cartoons, they bring it into schools, they doing stuff right now that against our whole belief system, and it's shaking up our houses now. And it goes back to the beginning in Genesis when God had cursed the serpent. He said he was going to put an enmity between the woman and the serpent, and the serpent seed and the woman's seed. And he said that the serpent was going to bruise the heel of the feet of the woman, and the woman of the seed of the woman is going to crush his head. So we got to realize there's two seeds, two races in this earth battling right now. And that's the seed of the serpent, seed of the woman. And right now, we are faced with being bruised, our heels being bruised. And that's exactly what we face with in this, not only in this country, but around the world. Now, we have countries that's right now that's resisting it, and they laughing at us because we trade ourselves as a godly nation. Now we the godless nation.
Thank you.
And you can see it.
Thank you.
And see, here's the problem that we have it right now in our country. We have, even in our ministries, we have leaders that have voices that's not saying, they're not actually using their voices to actually teach. First of all, we have a lot of people that sit inside churches that's spiritual illiterate. They don't have the foundation of God in their heart, so they don't know how to stand and fight for him. And if he's somebody that you want to fight for, then you're going to stand up. Anything that you believe in, you're going to fight for. And I tell you this, if the ISIS can believe in what they believe, you see what they do. They're ready to die for what they believe in, and they're willing to bring the pain because they believe in that stuff.
Bill, nobody's ready to die for what they believe in. Not in this country. Nobody's ready to die for God. They don't even want to go to jail for God right now. Because when the gays come to
the
church,
that's the problem we having. That's the problem we having. That's the problem that, you know, it's not only what the ruling, it's the leaders that we have that's not standing up and having a voice, and it's the body or the sheep or whatever you want to call us, that's the one raising the sand right now, because they don't see no leaders, so we stepping up as the leaders now.
Won't relinquish the power. The leaders won't relinquish the power, because right now
they want everybody to be under their control, under their mind control, and they don't want their finances or they don't want their livelihood.
Oh, did you say that? Did you say something about finances?
They don't want their livelihood disturbed. None of the big major voices out here, and I don't want to start naming them, but they didn't want to make a comment because they don't want their worlds disturbed. They don't want their livelihood disturbed, and they are friends with the world. I'm not saying that we bashing gays and all that. That's their life. They can do what they want to do, but I just don't want that stuff over here. You know what I'm saying? I don't want you to shove it down my throat. Like, I got to accept that, because I'm not going to accept that type of lifestyle, and you're not going to teach my children that. And that's where I got a problem. You can't teach my children what I haven't taught them.
Did you?
I mean, it's going to be people my children go to school with, and they're going to cuss, they're going to do all that stuff. I haven't taught them that.
Mm-hmm.
But they strengthen in the way where when they do go there, they know what's right from wrong. But see, these people trying to condition and put that stuff subconscious.
Thank you.
Subconscious as much of my children, and confuse my children of who to believe between me and them. And that's where we got a problem at.
That's where we got the problem at.
And people sit in the churches not understanding because they've been following so many different leaders. They're so connected to those leaders. When a leader say this is the person they're going to vote for, they vote for that person. The leader, they saying nothing about the situation. Guess what? They putting on they on Facebook with the gay pride profiles. These are Christians with gay profile, gay pride profiles for and celebration of gay pride. How can you do that when you have a father that said it's an abomination?
No, no.
That means a spiritual gap of understanding who you should stand, who you should serve, and who you stand for. It's not to say that we, like you said earlier, it's not that we supposed to actually bash people or we trying to shove our what we believe in down their throat, but we saying, hey, you made this a law of the land. We didn't make a law of the land to make you serve Jesus. We didn't make the law of the land to make you do stuff that's by his laws. We didn't make those laws. We didn't make laws, or we didn't even push for something. We just let everybody live their life and choose to live how they want to by their free will without making laws. I think the government is putting their hands behind everybody's livelihoods. They are in control of people's personal lives instead of governing the country, instead of governing our defense system, making a way where job creation could be created, doing a new tax reform, you know, stuff like that they need to be concentrating on. They actually stepping into people's lives now. Now they're stepping into our privacy, they're stepping into our lives, and it's so much of government right now, so much government control. The people is up in an uproar, and it's a big division that's starting with everybody. I mean, people in your own church, and one church house is fighting about same-sex, they stance on same-sex marriage, they stance on black and a Confederate flag. It's so much fighting, infighting, and racism, and everything going on right now, so much state of confusion. It's all because big government want to step into everybody's lives, and the church leaders haven't stood up for the rights of free will and understanding and making sure certain laws are not put in where it's going to affect everybody's belief system, because that's where if an atheist want to be an atheist, let them be. But don't put a law in it where atheists got to serve Jesus, or don't put a law in it where we have to accept what the atheists want. You know, so we got to understand what's going on. It's not just about the gay movement. It's about these laws that they're putting in place with the gay movement, and nobody talking and nobody standing up and nobody fighting and nobody saying that ain't good. So right now, there's only one person that actually, out of 9 Supreme judges, only one person was a deciding factor whether it's going to be or not. And I tell you, they was bought off. They was paid off. And those people, them little percentage of people that's fighting this, the LGBT community, whatever, whoever the organization, they got some money and they got some power and they got big people behind them that say, okay, well, let's wipe this Christian
stuff. Bill, wait a minute.
Let's wipe this up.
Wait a minute. Who has more money than the church?
Well, you're right. We have a lot of money, but see, we don't see that money. We don't. It's going. The money that we have is going to. That's why you see so many preachers with jets and all that stuff.
Oh,
you
know, Lord.
And you see you see a lot of stuff goes. It's not funneling to the people or the community or the community services or feeding the poor. It's not that money, that billions of dollars, the trillions of dollars that the church as a whole, especially in the African-American churches, that they actually accumulate. It's not. There's no evidence of where that money's going.
Well,
evidence of people prospering.
Let me get in here for a second, Bill, because I know you from Detroit, but you're in L.A. right now, yes. Right?
Yes, right.
Okay. So what do you think about how Detroit is the one major city that has more churches than anywhere in the country and letting the Church of Satan come in here and set up?
Now I got an issue with that. And I know my battle with that guy. You know, even I have a ministry that's there, and I talk when I post and I say stuff like this, I get a lot of mixed emotions about how my stance is, but I'm only going to stand in the Word of God. When you know about me, and everybody that know me, I'm going to stand in the Word of God. I even when I do stuff wrong, I kind of like bring it out to everybody so everybody can see the flaws I have, so they can understand how I'm going to deal with this situation.
Right.
Because I feel like we got to be we got to be on the up and up. But I could tell you one, I mean, I know I got a little activist in me, and I say there's no way in the world with 5,000 churches or more, I don't know how many churches, it might be 10,000 now, but with all the churches that's inside the city of Detroit, there's no way a temple of Satan should be standing up. The devil should be sprayed. But see, I believe in spiritual power. I believe in spiritual power, and I believe when the devil was near a person of God, they tremble. They're gonna manifest. They're gonna say some stuff to make you cast the devil out. And I believe that when the demons tremble and fear when they're in the presence of a person that have the presence of God in their life. There is no reason that in that house in Detroit, a Satan, a temple, should even have an unveiling of that statue that they're about to put up. That statue right there, see, that's letting me know right now the principality that's over the city of Detroit. When you ride in a plane, when you fly the plane, you have to experience turbulence. When you leave out of Detroit and when you come in Detroit, it's a strong turbulence that happens in that plane. And then when you get off the plane, the skies in Detroit is different from the skies in L.A. or some of the other places I visit. It's a gray, darkened clouds that actually, even in the sun, that you can actually see clouds hover over the city. That's principalities that's over that city because, first of all, it's a spiritual city. And by it being a spiritual city, some people ain't of God when they pray up to the heavens. What happens is they release the gates and the portals to demons and not God, not praying straight to God because of the stuff that they deal with. A lot of times when you got all these churches and they're not of God, but they're playing with God and they're playing with God money and they go into these prayer meetings, that's spiritual. You open up spiritual channels because you're trying to penetrate where God is at. So when you're trying to, your prayer is trying to reach heavens, you have to go through different first and second, third heavens to even get to God, and you have to deal with the principalities of the air and the power of darkness and the spiritual wickedness in high places. You have to deal with that. So if you ain't right and you unclean and praying, all these unclean people praying and spiritual religion stuff, the spirituality of their life is opening up spiritual portals for demons, and that's what's actually terrorizing the city right now. You have demons stepping and possessing and influencing people to be murderers, rapists, everything. Because right now, I tell you, the spirit of the Antichrist is in this country. And since the spirit of the Antichrist is in this country, you got the spirit of Antichrist, you got the spirit of the beast, and you got the spirit of the false prophet all in line right now, especially in this country. You got the Hollywood and media. These people operate under the spirit of the false prophet, and you have the beast, which is the spirit of the beast. That's what the government is operating out of right now. So they work hand in hand. Now the Antichrist spirit is here, and it's mightily. They haven't taken form, shape, or form yet, and right now we don't even know who they are. We could be looking at the Antichrist. We don't know.
We don't know.
The spirit is here so strong. His spirit here is so strong that the city of Detroit, you got to look at Michigan. Michigan is a fight, and it have a mitten hand. It's the only state in the whole on the whole globe that you can actually see a shape. And that's a shape of a hand, shape of a mitten. First of all, we're a fighting city. We're surrounded by five waters. Five waters. You remember five is the grace, and the water is spirit. And when you look at that, we are a land of creation. We are the land that got the hand of God on. And see, when you got the hand of God on it, and you allow devils to come in there, because you got to remember, God gave us the keys in the beginning to dominate this earth, and then Adam got himself tricked out of the key. And now Jesus had came back to get that key, and anybody get it from Jesus, they get it. But see, what's happened is Jesus is not Lord over people's lives no more. He's not Lord over the churches. He's not Lord over the preachers. So what's happened is the devil can still, he have that key to that region, and he's going to terrorize. And since that's a creative city with a lot of powerful people that actually come from great, like my wife said, great people come from Great Lakes. And right now, man, there are so many great people in the city of Detroit that's actually being hindered. They're under, it's like a kryptonite. It's like kryptonite. Detroit is like kryptonite to them, where they can't even move past. They can't even move forward because they got spirits fighting them. They only not got political stuff and opportunities from who they are and their skin color and all that. They got a spiritual force fighting them to try to keep them from making it, because those people would change the world if they make it. And what's happening is they, since the city of Detroit have so many spiritual power, that devil said, I feel at home in the city of Detroit.
Wow.
And now we have churches that ain't still today know that Devil about to have an unveiling party on July 25th.
Oh, is it 25th?
July 25th.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, July 25th, and I'm in California. I know all this stuff happening. Look, and July 25th, they're getting ready to have an unveiling party. They was going to have it last week.
Right.
They pushed it back. Mm-hmm. They pushed that back to get more support. They wanted the same-sex marriage stuff to pass. So right. Now that they got it, they about to have the unveiling because this is the final blow. This is the final blow, and they are actually coming to Detroit to do it. The land that everybody wants. That's a land of pure water, land of creativity, land where spirits actually control the whole country. Mm-hmm. And you got to understand, they about to unveil and they have about to set their first tempo in the city of Detroit. That should never be.
That should they never should be. Fighting right now. Not at all.
They should be fighting right now. When Jesus was at the when he went before Pontius Pilate, he said, "Look at your people." He left, and I'm going to paraphrase this. Jesus looked at him and said, "Hey, my people, they're my people, they'll be fighting." And that's right now. We should be fighting right now. We ain't got to we ain't got to bash people. We ain't got to do that. But we need to take a stance. We need to do something that's going to be effective. And there need to be a unity in the churches in Detroit because we got a lot of power there.
We're not ready for all that, Bill. We're not ready for all of that. We're not ready.
No, but they got to do it now. See, it's all about, are you willing to lose everything that you have right now to do the work of God, to save a generation, to save the next children, to save the name of the Lord in this house, in the city, in the state, and even in the country, and in the world. It's all about what we want to do. Or we might as well throw the Bible away and close down all the churches because it don't work.
People are not ready to lose everything. People aren't ready to preach in tents. People are not ready to stand on the corners and do these type of things, Bill. This is why people like me and you that are in charge of media have to use what we have to bring the word out.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. And that's what, you know, it's good to have the platform and it's good to support each other so we can have a stronger platform so we can do a greater work. And I believe that once our heart in the right place like it is right now, I think doors will open up anyway, even if, you know, people don't want to deal with us because of our stance in this United States. Hey, we from the old school. We grew up in the good times in the United States. We grew up when this country was good.
Mm-hmm.
Even though we might have crazy presidents in our time, too, our land was good because they just did their thing. Even if they did some quicker stuff with money, they ain't mess with
right.
our lives.
Right.
You know? And the gays still was happy. They still had their little gay bars and all that other stuff. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But ain't nobody messed with them. Nobody beat them up. Nobody put them on the cross and burned them. You know what I'm saying? That happened to African Americans.
Nobody hung them.
So you can't compare those our life our struggle with the gay struggle. They
no,
didn't
never
have a really only struggle they had is wanting to be accepted for their little lust they got. You know what I'm saying? So it's cool. It's the people that got lust for women and they marry, and they keep on scoring different women. So that's a problem. That's a problem people have, period. When they have lust, they got problems. And we don't care. You know, I know a person, you know, he don't like, because I'll be like, man, you got to stop messing with your wife, man. You know, one day you're not going to have, he don't even want to hear that from me. You know, he don't want to hear that. And so, you know, when you tell people to, you know, what they should do that's going to help them out, they don't want to hear it. And that's the same with the gay stuff going on. You know, they don't want to hear that. They want you to accept it. And since they get to the point where they so rebellious with it, they want to make a law to make you respect them. And that's where we got a problem.
Right.
You know, don't make me do nothing. Because I got a problem with that. I don't even think the President of the United States should even endorse nothing. I think he should stay neutral and let things happen. You know what I'm saying? If we're going to have these issues, let the American people vote. Because we did vote. And a lot of the states that we voted in
didn't even want it.
Yeah. See, in California, the people voted to ban homosexual same-sex marriage. They voted to ban it. It was the Supreme Court. It was the President of the United States who endorsed it to the point he didn't like what happened, and he went to the Supreme Court, and they overrided the people's vote. Right now what's happening is the Supreme Court had overrided the people's vote. And
that don't make no sense.
We banned that, and now the Supreme Court is overriding the ban and the wishes of the people that voted for these people in the House. That's the problem we're having right now. We gave the government
too much power. Too much power.
We gave them too much power, and now It's like Rumpelstiltskin. They give you all those benefits, but in the end, you're going to have to pay for it.
Hey, Bill, I'm glad you came on the show today. I am so glad that we had this talk, man. Man, we could talk for hours about this. I wish I had another hour to talk to you, but I'm riding up on these last few minutes. I gotta say thank you to you. I'm gonna hit you back on Facebook in a few minutes, but I gotta say bye to the people. I'll call you back in a little bit.
Okay, you have a good one.
All right, you too. Man, people, I mean, first I said it, then you said it. That's confirmation. Then Bill said it. Confirmation. Hey, ain't much more we can do about it now. We can't accept it. And you can't let people tell you have to accept it. That's just not who we are. We got to stay vigilant. We gotta fight for what we believe in. And stop sitting on the sidelines acting like that's where we got to be. Me? Yeah, I'm going down there. I'm taking the protection of God with me when I go down there to that Satanist church. But I ain't going alone. I want to see you there. But I know I probably won't. Check it out. I will see y'all next week. No. I will see you Friday. I always mess that up. I'll see you Friday. And we're going to talk more about this. Because church, it's your fault that the people look at us this way as weak. And not having no power. Get a backbone, church, and let's go get this work. I'll see y'all next Friday.
Show me your glory. Show me your glory, God. Show me your glory. Show me your glory. Awed by your beauty, lost in your eyes. I want to walk in your presence like Jesus Christ. Your glory surrounds.
A portion of this program has been brought to you by Worship Center Network, Worship Center Studios, and Worship Center Radio. And by myself, Juan Johnson, Blaine Irving, and Dr. Rhoda Bird. Hey, I enjoy my show. I like when you call in. Give me your opinions. Talk to me. It's not my show. It's your show. I'm just a facilitator, and I will see you Friday. Thank you for supporting me, and thank you for your generous donations that keep this show on the air. I love you, and I'll see you Friday.
I want all of you, Jesus. Oh, you, I want to be used by you. I want more of you, Lord. Oh, Lord. Set a fire down in my heart, oh, God.